So how do we
are we talking about that?
How do we feel about Forsaken pricing, everybody? That is the topic that we were actually talking about. Forsaken is priced at, and I still have the numbers here, it looks like
still
the base
sale.
Costs $39.99 for Forsaken. The annual version of the game with the annual pass is $69.99. If you want digital deluxe, it is $80. So just the base game without the expansions or annual pass is $39.99. And the cost right now includes the fact that you have to buy Destiny and both DLCs, which Bungie did clarify that they're addressing.
Well, they're saying that potentially there might be a skew later on.
Yeah.
Nothing concrete.
There's no update. You have to own Warmind, Curse of Osiris, and Destiny 2 to play Forsaken.
Yeah. And the best price you can get looks like for the $39.99 version and Destiny 2 with the stuff that you need, it's like it's $80 for just the base without annual pass. With the annual pass, it's $110.
Yeah, and
if you're coming in fresh.
Yeah, and right now there's like Fortnite and then even Battlefield and Division. There's a bunch of people who came out at E3 and said, hey, we're going to do annual pass or like DLC a little different. This is tough for people, I think, to latch onto and go, okay, well, if I didn't like those two, why do I need to buy it?
Here's what I think they should do. I think... Okay, there's two conversations here. There's one about the base pricing of Forsaken for those of us that have been playing the game.
Yep.
How do we feel about that? And then what do we think they should do for players that are new coming into the game? The new SKU needs to be priced at $80 and it needs to include the annual pass.
Right, in
That's what I think.
The annual pass, I'd be okay with that.
Yes, $80, I think that's the price point the community is looking for. Well, I mean, of course they want as cheap as possible, but I think $80 is a fairly fair price point for Destiny 2 base game, Curse of Osiris, Warmind, the Forsaken expansion, and the annual pass. I think $80 is a fair price to ask for that much content.
For all that? Yeah. I think that's good.
Looking at all that, I don't know how they would justify that, but that's what I think the community would
be
like.
Great price.
This makes sense.
Because people are saying right now the annual pass is like, it's now additional versus previously it was kind of, they're structuring it a little bit differently. So. Mm-hmm.
It's funny that, like, at a base, what was bothering me when I first saw the pricing was that I just think Forsaken with, if you need to get Destiny 2 and the content, because there's probably something going on behind the scenes, maybe you need the curse content, you're going to be interfacing through those areas. I don't know.
Yeah, exactly.
Whatever the reason, if you need all that content,
and then
forcing you to get it, just sell it for $60. You didn't buy the last stuff, and here's the new thing that's 40. Let's just call it $60 like a regular game. I think that's easy.
With annual pass or no?
Not with annual pass.
And then annual pass is 20.
Which, that's, well, how much
so
is it now?
Six, it's annual 60, pass. You're good to go. And annual, sorry, it's more than that.
Well, the annual pass is $30,
if we,
bucks, right?
If, so but it's the standard's $39.99. It's $69.99 with the annual pass, so it's $30.
But $1,000, meaning we were off by, you recommended $80 for both. So that would be a $50 price point with a $30 pass, right?
Yeah. I was saying they're in such a hard spot. Like, they have to figure out a good solution for new players coming into their game, and they want new players to come in with this expansion. And also, it sounds like you're not getting access to random rolls if you don't expand to this stuff. Like, you're not getting access to Gambit, the new areas.
They didn't say that about random rolls. Because there's season four changes coming.
Yeah.
That's like a sandbox change, but it sounds like you need this expansion. I don't want to spread misinformation, so I'm just speaking right now. So please,
we don't know.
Take this with a grain of salt. We need to do more investigative journalism.
They will have season four.
Yeah, but we don't. Yeah. But that's the thing. Right now, we don't
know
what's
going to have access to the new
features. The issues. Yeah. So it's like it's okay. When you think about what they're offering, it's messaged a little bit awkwardly, and your brain is trying to go, okay, well, what's which part of the game, and what am I going to have access to?
And when I have to use my brain, I get mad.
No, totally. But if
as the internet,
if Recollection serves, though, the roadmap is only for the seasonal changes, right?
But they haven't detailed anything like past Forsaken in the roadmap, though, right?
Bottom line is, it's confusing.
It is. And that's kind of what we're saying. There's a bunch of people who think a certain way, but because the annual pass is different and the price of it, and then I need this, there's a lot of different pieces of it.
By Gamescom, they've come together, they figure out a smart messaging strategy for their pricing structure, because right now it's really weird. And just going back a little bit, the Forsaken base cost with the annual pass at $69.99, I think that needs to be 60, and I think the base cost needs to be 30. I think 40 is a little.
And they
I think they're about $10 too high on everything.
Hmm. Well, they haven't announced like their bundle yet, right?
Well, this is
that's
question.
That's what they're
saying. The digital deluxe.
If it's coming, if something else.
But there
you're right.
One bundle with everything. You're right. That's what's missing. My personal read on it is
we'll probably see that in like August or something, right?
Maybe. Probably. Hopefully. Like, this is what we need to see. That's what happened last time.
I feel like it's kind of normal for this to happen, even though it sucks for the consumer, but they're waiting to see how many pre-orders they get, how much the demand is there, and if it's not quite there, they will incentivize you with something like this, and they'll wait to do it.
Be sure to subscribe to our channel for more Destiny coverage. I'll even have Zerg give you exactly what you wanted if you do. Apparently, I can't do that. You should still subscribe.